We all know that fruit and vegetables are good for us, with 5 portions a day being the recommended amount. But it would appear that the humble beetroot has something a little extra special to offer. Groundbreaking trials by sports and health science researchers show that drinking 0.5 litre of beetroot juice a day can help improve endurance levels due to the vegetable's naturally high levels of nitrates.
We found a significant reduction in the oxygen cost of exercise, which implies that the energy demand of exercising at a particular work rate is significantly lower. When we extended our studies to ask our subjects to exercise to exhaustion, we found that they were able to go significantly longer at the same high intensity work rate. So there seemed to be a performance benefit as well. The reduction in the oxygen cost of exercise during submaximal work was of the order of 5 to 10%, which is really quite meaningful. And then the improvement in the times to exhaustion at a high intensity work rate were of the order of 15 to 20%.
The findings have prompted keen interest from across the world, as they could prove highly significant in competitive sport. And that's particularly timely with the 2012 London Olympics on the horizon.
People around the world, athletes and coaches and sports organisations, are interested in the impact that this might have on their performance, some of which we'll get to know about, others we won't, because obviously competitive teams want to get that advantage over their rivals. But yeah, I think there will be a sort of a health legacy that should come after the Olympics.
This breakthrough research could offer even further health benefits. The findings stem from earlier work carried out by academics in Scandinavia who use sodium nitrate. But Exeter's research, using naturally occurring nitrates, has shown that beetroot juice may also help to reduce blood pressure. This exciting breakthrough has led to dialogues between the university and various clinicians, health trusts, medical research funders, health-related charities, and blue-chip nutrition-focused companies.
We're also interested in the application that this might have in other populations that may be impaired by their condition, whether it's older age, which as we know can lead to a reduction in physical capacity, or in various diseases, cardiovascular disease or metabolic disease such as diabetes. So there's a range of different populations that we'd like to explore our findings in. We and others are at the beginning really of this story, so there are dialogues going on with NHS and with various charities, the elderly and other ones that deal with medical conditions, to really try to use this a little bit more practically.
Indeed, the research at Exeter continues at pace, as trials are now focusing on the older population as well as the sporting world. It's believed this development will promote not only further partnerships, but also significant scientific breakthroughs.
This is one of the sports nutrition stories of the decade. I think this is one of those discoveries, for want of a better word, that transcends. It's not just performance, but it has a health application and implication as well. Yes.